All right, maybe you're grabbing some pictures of a solar eclipse or even a lunar eclipse. It doesn't matter. This tutorial is going to show you how to assemble them into a sequence inside of Photoshop. Obviously, I've put all my eclipse images here inside of Lightroom. I'll also show you how to do this without Lightroom. So the first thing I did is I just selected a few and then put them into a separate collection here. So here, see how this has a little glow around there? That is fine, but what I'm going to do is just go to the Develop module, and I'm just going to push the blacks in just a little bit to make sure that the black areas are a proper black. Now, if I want to sync this, all I do is just hit Control A, select all the rest of the images. So there's the one that we've adjusted with the black. We're going to hit Sync, and we're just going to check None. And now I'm just going to turn on Basic and then choose Synchronize. And what that's going to do is it's just going to make sure that they all have that solid black. So I want to select all of these images. So I'm going to select one, hold the Shift key, click on the last one. So I've selected them all. And in the film strip, right click, and we're going to choose to edit in. Now, rather than going to edit in Photoshop, we can go down, we can open them as layers. Now, these images I've shot here are raw files. So if I want to retain them as raw and still load them in layers, I can open as smart object layers in Photoshop. So if you've shot in any other format, just open in layers. Otherwise, choose open in smart object layers. And this will launch Photoshop and it will start to load these images up into layers. I'm just going to dock the layers panel so it makes it easier for us to access. Now, if you didn't use Lightroom, I'll show you exactly how to get these into Photoshop. Choose File, Scripts, Load Files into a Stack. Then we go to the folder where you have the images. I've exported these from Lightroom. So if you're not using Lightroom, maybe you're using Bridge or however you're doing it, put the images you want to use into a separate folder, select them all, and then click Open. You'll see all of them here. Just click OK. So you can see they're loaded in a stack. I'm going to close that out. We're going to go back to the ones I loaded in from Lightroom. So it doesn't matter if you bought these in from Lightroom or you loaded them in directly using the other process. The steps from here on are exactly the same for both. So if you look in here, you'll notice that these are all stacked in layers. So what we need to do is position them. Now, here's the thing. If we change the blending mode, we're going to be able to see all of these at the same time. So let's grab the top layer, hold the Shift key, select the bottom layer. Now we've selected all the layers and we want to reveal them all. We're going to change the blending mode from normal to lighten. And here we are in light mode. What that does is it hides black, shows the bright areas. Now we can see all the parts of the eclipse at the same time. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. So what we need to do now is we need to assemble this. So why don't we do that? And let's make a selection around the area that we would probably want to have as far as spacing. Let's grab one side and we're going to hit the space bar to move it around. I'm going to start from the edge and drag it out. So I think the next one could start about on that there. So we're looking at about 1100, 1150 if you look at the width there. Maybe we could go all the way up to 1200. Let's go to 1200 for each one. So how many of these circles are we going to have? Well, if we just want to see how many layers we have, if we go under this setting here, choose layer count, it tells us we've got 13 layers. All right, so that means 1200 times 13. Okay, so if we choose 1200 times 13, that means we need 15,600 as far as our width. All right, so we know we want to go 15,600 wide. Let's have a look here and see how tall this document is. So if we go under Document Dimensions, the height is always the second number, which is 3240. So let's grab our crop tool. We're going to choose width, height, and resolution. So we're going to type in 15,600 and do px, so we know it's pixel. That's our width. And now we want our height to be 3240. So we grab that. And then all we need to do now is just size it so that our crop box is the size of the height of our image. And as you drag it out, you'll see it'll get to 15,600 when we're exactly there. And then just hit enter. Let's hit control zero. That just puts it in the middle. Perfect. All right, what we need to do is make sure we've got a black background. And if we decide, like, maybe later on we're going to expand it or change it, we want to keep that black background. So why don't we go and grab an adjustment layer, and we're going to choose solid color and choose black. Click OK. Now, if we drag that layer to the very, very bottom, we can see, bingo, that's going to fill that up. Now, we don't want to accidentally move it or select it, so we're just going to hit the lock tool. This is going to lock that background so we don't select it by accident. Now, what we need to do is we need to divide this up. We know we've got 13 different segments. So what we can do is we can set up a grid. So let's do that right now. We're going to go under View, go to Guides, and then we're going to choose a new guide layout. So we're going to turn that on. So what we're going to do is we're going to give this one 14 columns, and this is going to give us 13 spaces in there. And then for rows, we're going to set this to 2, and this is going to give us a center. Make sure your gutter is set to 0, margin is off. And if we click OK, what we've done now is we've set up a guide that is going to help us position everything perfectly. All right, if we want to find our center, it's quite simple. We're just going to change this to percent. And we know 50% is the center. So right there is going to be the center of our document. And we're going to choose the layer that represents totality. And we're going to pop that right on the center there. Now, I can use align and distribute, but because these were framed differently, we're not going to be able to get away with that on this particular shot. So what we're going to have to do is just do it one at a time and position it. All right, what we're going to do now is we're going to grab another guide, and we're going to set that to the very top and the bottom of our circle. And this is going to help us align things better. All right, so what we want to do now is, why don't we start with after totality? So we're going to grab the smallest section here and drag that. And now we're going to line it up at the top. We're looking for the center there with that guide. Perfect. Let's go down, grab the next one. Great. And I'm just going to align these. If you wanted to put a curve or something in there, you feel free to do that. And I'm just going to do just a perfect alignment on these for now, because I just want to kind of keep it simple. And by the way, the focal length I was using here was 560, so I was using a 400 millimeter lens with a 1.4 extender when I shot these. And this is from the last eclipse at Casper, Wyoming. And hopefully you'll get good weather and you're going to get beautiful, you know, eclipse wherever you are. Now, if we choose View, Guides, Clear Guides, we can see there is our assembled eclipse. All right, so I would save this as a PSD, so you have all your layers and everything. You want to make further adjustments. And then just choose File, Export, Save for Web if you wanted to share this on social media. And then just choose, I don't know, something like 1920 or whatever, you know, wherever you're going to share it. I'm going to use a quality of about 75, because above this, you're not really getting much more quality, and all you're doing is just making a larger file. And then you could save that out. So drop a comment underneath and let me know if you learned anything new in this tutorial. If you're new to the cafe, welcome. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.